take care of our teachers, and make Filipinos more employable. These were just some of President Marcos Jr.'s marching orders for incoming Education Chief Senator Sonny Anggara. Marcos Baird plans to simplify the curriculum to ensure Filipino students fully understand basic concepts, especially in science, technology, and mathematics, or STEM subjects. He cites the country's poor performance in international assessments. The president also called for improving the welfare of teachers through financial assistance and retraining.
We go back to make sure that everybody understands the basics, because marami pang hindi nasa grade 5 na, nasa grade 6 na, mahina pang basa. Yung mga simple na mathematics na exam, hindi nila kayang gawin. So yun ang kailangan talaga, basics. We have to go back to basics.
Marcos also requested Anggara to teach more Philippine history in schools, as he believes this adds to children's character building. DepEd was slammed by critics last year for supposedly attempting to whitewash the dictatorship of Marcos's father and namesake under the new Matatag curriculum.
The one thing I asked of him was to please teach our children Philippine history, because I have seen my children's workbooks and there's very little said about the history of the Philippines. And that is so, for me, that is so important, for the simple reason that that is what will make a child understand what it means to be a Filipino. Ito ang pinagdaanan ng aming lahi, kaya ganyan ang ugali namin dahil sa aming kasaysayan.
Federal Express Corporation, or FedEx, is doubling the size of its 17,000 square meters logistics facility inside the Clark International Airport in Pampanga. The base's Conversion and Development Authority says FedEx inked an agreement with the airport's operator, the Luzon International Premier Airport Development, for the new facility, which it says would offer opportunities for local businesses to boost their presence in international markets. This would also support the growing demand for e-commerce, freight, and cold chain shipments across the Asia-Pacific region. FedEx opened its Clark Hub in 2021, a state-of-the-art facility capable of sorting up to 9,000 parcels per hour with a freight handling area of 630 square meters. Corporate Stories, the renewable energy arm of the Ayala Group, ASIN, reports it has secured a 5-year syndicated green term loan and revolving credit facility totaling $150 million from a consortium of international financial institutions. These institutions include CTBC Bank, Malayan Banking Berhad, and Land Bank of Taiwan. The proceeds will be used to support ASIN's growth in the Asia-Pacific region. The company has about 4.8 gigawatt of attributable renewable capacity in operation and under construction. Meanwhile, Aboitiz Power confirms in a disclosure it has established a venture studio dedicated to building startups in the energy sector. Called the 1882 Energy Ventures, the studio will focus on startups in areas such as decentralized energy resources, electric mobility, among others. And finally, an announcement from budget carrier AirAsia. It says it will be having a system upgrade on Wednesday, July 10th. The airline says this will affect all flights from 7 p.m. on July 10 to 3 a.m. on July 11th. It notes the upgrade is expected to enhance the customer journey.